Vítám na tiskové konference samozřejmě za jednak Blakea Schilba, tak zároveň Petra Jechana, jakožto generálního manažera USK Praha. A nejprve dám slovo přímo Petrovi a poprosím ho o nějaké úvodní slovo a jak vlastně vznikla ta kooperace a co si od ní USK Praha slibuje.
Tak dobrý den, já bych taky poděkoval za vaši pozornost. Pro USK Praha je velkou ctí, že tady můžeme přivítat Blakea Schilba a že s ním můžeme spolupracovat ve finální části sezóny. Přestože Folimanka je spojena v současné době hlavně s výchovou mladých hráčů, tak právě ikony velkých basketových osobností byly a jsou spojeny s Folimankou. My jsme velmi rádi, že tato původní myšlenka, která má nějakou historii, takže se nám ji podařilo dotáhnout do finální fáze. A pro tuto finální část sezóny můžeme zrealizovat tuto spolupráci, která má více cílů. Já bych to nazval synergickým efektem, kdy na jedné straně příchod Blakea je samozřejmě pro finálovou část sezóny a účast USK v playoff velmi důležitá po sportovní stránce, ale právě protože jsem avizoval dlouhodobou strategii USK výchovy mladých hráčů, tak právě osobnosti, jako je Blake Schilb, historicky mají velký podíl i na spolupráci a výchově mladých hráčů. Takže pro nás ten efekt není jenom výsledkový, ale je výkonový, ale především i kromě utkání a sportovní stránky je to i mimo hřiště profilování a rozvoj mladých hráčů, protože v Čechách ne mnoho mladých hráčů má možnost spolupracovat s takovými osobnostmi z významných evropských soutěží, jako je Blake. A samozřejmě to, že naši mladí hráči vidějí úspěch českých reprezentantů na mezinárodních soutěžích, tak jedna věc je vidět a jedna věc s nimi sdílet zkušenosti. Takže v tom vidíme jako obrovský přínos. Ten efekt je i z hlediska českého basketu má větší rozměr. Protože jsme využili, ta myšlenka vznikla nejenom ve vztahu k soutěžní fázi USK, ale právě protože Blake, věřím, bude z jednou klíčových osobností jara pro český basketbal, kdy budeme aktivovat znova úspěšný český reprezentační tým z mistrovství světa před olympijskou kvalifikací, tak tato myšlenka vznikla právě proto, že Blake v této velmi složité sezóně, aby se mohl dobře připravit, tak by mohl využít potenciál a platformu Folimanky, protože Folimanka nabízí velmi dobré technické zázemí pro přípravu. Takže ta myšlenka není jenom z pohledu soutěží, ale z pohledu toho, že jsme nabídli možnost přípravy Blakea tady na Folimance v následujících dvou měsících, a protože samozřejmě pro klíčový sportovní soutěže příprava není jenom tréninková, ale je ideální zápasová, tak právě ta myšlenka spojit přípravu Blakea s možností zapojit se do finální části sezóny v playoff pro USK právě vidíme právě ten oboustranný efekt přínos jak pro USK, tak pro český basketbal jako takový. Takže já věřím, že toto bude obrovská energie pro mladý tým. My už jsme samozřejmě tuto informaci sdíleli s našimi hráči a je vidět, že to je obrovská energie, obrovská motivace pro finálovou část sezony právě v takto náročném období, jako tato sezona je, tak vidím, že to je obrovská energie pro celý klub, takže věřím, že to bude přínos nejenom pro nás a pro celý český basketbal. Děkuji.
Já děkuji Petrovi za komentář a teďka už dám prostor Blakeovi a pak samozřejmě prostor pro vaše případné dotazy. So B, how was the first feeling that you are back in Czech Republic and you're going to be part of the Cooperativa NBL and you will wear for a couple games the USK Prague jersey?
It's a very good feeling to be able to be here back in Czech Republic, you know, where I started my career professionally, and knowing the history of the club and you know, the direction that the club is going, it's a great opportunity for both parties to join each other and to be able to potentially have some success in these playoffs. It's very exciting for me first off because it's been a long time since I've been able to play basketball almost now professionally. It's a year. It's the longest tenure of time that I've taken off from the court. in a long time, so or ever. So to be able to have this opportunity again, I wasn't sure if it was ever gonna happen again. And to be able to be here with familiar faces and back in the Czech Republic, it's a big blessing.
Thank you very much. Nyní dám prostor samozřejmě vašim dotazům. Asi bychom nejdřív začali s Petrem Jachanem, protože předpokládám, že hlavní těžiště dotazů bude na Blakea. Tak se chci vás zeptat případně, jestli máte na Petra nějaké dotazy.
Chci možná zeptat teda pana Jachana, na jak dlouho je ta smlouva, jste dohodnutý do konce sezóny, jakoby do konce playoff, nebo to bude nějaký dlouhodobější, nebo jaký jsou výhody?
Jak jsem avizoval, tak to jsou jakoby dva cíle. Samozřejmě my jsme si vědomi, že jsme ve finálové části sezóny. Naštěstí, když ta myšlenka vznikala, tak jsme jako nebyli úplně ještě jistí, že budeme hrát playoff, teď už to víme. Ale samozřejmě nevíme, jak dlouho, takže se to může mít velmi rychlej spát. Takže ta spolupráce má větší rozměr než jenom zápasový. Určitě jsme domluveni, že tady bude s naším týmem se dva měsíce připravovat před finální částí přípravy české reprezentace, protože ať USK bude nebude hrát dokonce v playoffové části, tak se tady bude skupina mladých hráčů připravovat, takže tady bude mít optimální podmínky. Takže ta spolupráce je na dva měsíce z hlediska vytvoření podmínek pro jeho přípravu před olympijskou kvalifikací. Z hlediska klubové účasti v kooperativě je to pro zbývající část sezóny jednoznačně. To znamená, počet utkání bude záviset, jak dlouho budeme hrát, my s to uvědomujeme. Samozřejmě vnímám, že pro Blakea ta soutěž je, řekl bych, startovací. A myslím, že to je optimální kombinace, že on vlastně se bude vracet do plný zápasový zátěže a přestože kooperativa není top evropská soutěž, tak je to podle mě ideální platforma pro, jak řekl, warm-up, zapojení do zápasu, takže pro nás to, nám to připadá jako zajímavá kombinace. A samozřejmě naším cílem je odehrát co nejvíc zápasů, protože každý zápas, věřím, bude optimální pro náš tým a věřím, že i pro český basket.
Děkuju. Zeptám se ještě, jestli má někdo dotaz na Petra. Tak nyní dám prostor přímo vašim dotazům na Blakea.
Já možná začnu. Hi Blake, it's Jan Jarov from Czech Daily Sport. Can you just tell me how last year without basketball looked for you? What did you do in the state? What was your basketball routine? How hard it was?
Ciao, Jan. Yes, this last year was very uncertain, you know, I think for everybody because of the pandemic. But, you know, for me personally, with basketball, having, you know, not playing and not knowing which direction my career was going to go, it allowed me to pursue different opportunities as well. And also spend a lot of time with my family, you know, and be with my wife and kids, and you know, go back to our house where we haven't spent a lot of time, you know, because of my career in Europe. So as far as basketball goes, it was uncertain. I would train during the week, and I would play on Tuesdays and Sundays in a league where. It wasn't a professional level. It was pretty good competition, but it wasn't the level where I wanted to play. So there was always a constant search for being in shape and getting better and still that uncertainty of if I was ever going to play again. So after many discussions and you know, with Mike and you know, the club, finally, we came to some agreement where, you know, we could come together and join forces. And even it's later in the season, it's still a great opportunity.
I'm not sure, but can you tell me why did you decide not to go back to France? You didn't have any contact there with Ramesh, or?
Yes, actually, I did around. January, I had some opportunities to play in a couple clubs that presented some offers, but I felt the timing just wasn't right. I wasn't, you know, ready to make this move, you know, and jump right back into basketball right away. Plus, there were some other things that were going on as far as business ventures, you know, that I wanted to try and pursue before getting back on the court.
What's your business back in US?
Yeah. With some former teammates from some other clubs, have some business.
Did you think a little bit about retirement in this difficult time, because you are?
Surely, it crossed my mind several times, and you know, it's when you don't play for so long, after playing, you know, 12, 13 years nonstop, and then all of a sudden you have this break, you start to question, you know, am I too old, or am I out of shape, or is it time to look for a new career or something like this? But and always in the back of your mind as a competitor, you want to break that cycle, right? And you want to continue to try to play no matter how old you get, or you know, no matter injuries or anything, you always want to try to raise the bar.
You look in a good shape. How hard were you practicing?
Thanks. Often it was difficult still because you know, many of the COVID protocols, it was difficult for practicing. A lot of the time it had to be you know, private practices, and for that matter, many people wouldn't attend. You know, it was mostly myself training or on the track, you know, just running for endurance and things like this. But I feel good.
You faced in US, were you playing, for example, with high school guys or college guys, or?
A lot of the time it was guys who graduated from universities and, you know, had some professional careers, but not very long ones, or former professional players who were playing and were done playing, and a little bit older as well.
Yeah. Were you dominating them?
I try to be humble, but yeah, you know, I dominate wherever I go, so.
So you are back in Czech Republic mostly because of your desire to play for national team, do I get it right?
I think first and foremost, the desire was just to play basketball, you know, and the first priority is to play for USK, you know, and embrace the opportunity to be back on the court. But I think in the longer run, you know, after the season is finished, yes, it's a goal to continue to try to play for the national team.
How hard do you think it will be to play matches again? Because it's something completely different to play competitive matches and to just practice.
Basketball is basketball. I think, you know, getting in shape is the most important, or trying to continuously get in shape. What I think will be a little bit different is, you know, the atmosphere, you know, as I haven't had a chance to really play so many games without the fans or support. So, you know, this will be different. After all of my career, I've been able to have this, and now at this point, it's kind of stopped. So it may pose a change.
How many guys from USK do you know personally, or?
I know a few of the guys. Some of the guys were on the national team, you know, in some circuits, and you know, I did some research on some of the younger guys, and also I like to, you know, like a scout a little bit. So, of course, anybody that I wasn't familiar with just yet, I did some background checks and you know, see how they were doing in their careers as well.
Thank you,
Mike. Thank you.
Děkuju moc za dotazy. Jenom taky intermezzo, jestliže nebudeme potřebovat Petra, tak jestli se mnou souhlasíte, nebo tak Petr říká, že tady zůstane, dobře, nebudem ho vyhánět, tak poprosím o vaše další dotazy.
Hello, Blake, jeho pospíšil ČTK.
How big goal is for you, maybe the chance to get to Olympic Games this year, because it's a goal for everybody, and you said that you try to get to back to national team.
Yeah, it's a big goal, I think, for everybody, you know. Sure, you know, like I said, the first priority for me is to handle business here in with USK, and hopefully we can do something, you know, special in these playoffs, you know, that hopefully that the club has envisioned for this club to get better and better. So hopefully we can do this. But after, of course, the goal is to of course try to train and be ready for the national team circuit. I'm not 100% certain about the qualifications or the actual games themselves, so I haven't heard anything. It was quite disappointing last summer when everything was canceled, but I think everybody also has some hope, you know, that this year the Summer Olympics can bring everybody in the sports world together again.
Was the main reason that you not to that you choose not to retire, but not try to another challenge?
You know, one time I was just joking around my house, and I told my kids I was retiring, and they started to cry. So I was like, okay, I'm never going to retire then. And but you know, that a part of it is, you know, this was a lifestyle, you know, that my family was used to, and it was, of course, a big change for me, but for all of us. And you know, we agreed that Daddy wouldn't retire until it was on basically his own terms, you know. So not because of a pandemic stopping the sports world or seasons like this. I felt that it was forced, you know, to stop, when I don't think that anybody deserves that.
Are you in contact with Coach Ginzburg?
Yes, we spoke several times. He's I don't know, I haven't seen him since I've been here, but yes, we've been in contact, and I hope that, you know, I see him soon, and that he's doing well as well.
How are you ready to get to the youngest team in the Czech league? Because USK has a average the youngest team, and you are maybe the oldest one now.
Yeah, I'm certainly the oldest one, but I'm like Benjamin Button. So I'm just getting younger and younger every day.
Okay, and maybe last question, how do you see the specialty, because from USK Prague get to the career Tomáš Satoranský, Ondřej Balvin, and another members of national team, how do you see maybe the comeback to, you know, your comeback to the team where Czech stars was born?
You like we've mentioned, you know, a lot of these stars, you know, were younger starting their career here, and ended up blossoming throughout their career and still having a very successful career. And you know, the history behind USK has always been that, so that they get younger players and develop them, and after you can you see their potential everywhere. So like I said, being a part of that is great, especially towards the end of my career, to be able to practice and to play with these younger guys. You know, I can give them some of my experience and knowledge, and hopefully pass that to them and help them become even better players as well.
How are you looking forward to battles with Limburg?
It should be fun. It should be fun. You know, we'll cross that bridge when it comes. But you know, right now we have my first game this Sunday against Kolín, so this is my main focus for now.
So maybe win the final.
Maybe. I don't want to promise anything, but maybe it's possible.
Okay, thank you, Blake, and good luck.
Thank you.
Děkuji moc za další dotaz a teďka dám asi, nebo předpokládám, že Petr Hamták bude mít spoustu otázek, tak Peťo, pusť se do toho.
Už jenom trochu, tak vlastně většina byla řečena. So Blake, just couple of questions. Actually, I feel that Coach Ginsburg was always leaving a shop option as open. So was he sort of pushing you to get some job for this summer?
Yeah, he's always pushy, but we know how he is. you know, I think Coach Nano always has the right mindset, you know, for his players and for the people surrounding him, you know, to try and get them to bring the best out of them. So, you know, he always told me I can play until I was 45 years old because I'm not athletic and, you know, all I do is just move slow. So, you know, we were in contact about continuing to play. So, it was a great opportunity. And, you know, I think this was the best opportunity out of any of them, that presented themselves.
What about the teammates from the national team? So I get that you are still in contact. So were they surprised by your return?
Not so much. I spoke with Bochy a couple times and Andre, but you know, we haven't talked about this yet. So I'm waiting to hear, you know, what they will say, but. You know, I just seen that Bochy went to the last eight for the Champions League last night, so I'm sure he's, you know, he's got a lot on his plate right now too. So, and it's the time of the season where everybody is getting ready for the playoffs and getting really focused. So, you know, I think everybody is in their respective seasons and ready to finish strong.
If you haven't said it, so what should be your first game now?
What should be my first game? This Sunday. This Sunday is the first game against Colleen.
And how many minutes actually do you expect to play, or would you be capable of playing?
I'm really not sure. I think today will tell me a lot. You know, I'm a little bit. Jet lagged because this is the longest time I've, you know, been out of this time zone. But I'm excited to get on the court. We have practice after this and another one this afternoon. So I think that will tell me, you know, how I feel physically, and then the coaching staff, and will determine the amount of minutes or anything like this.
So let's say like 20 minutes should be like the minimum for the start, or?
That would be nice. You know, that would be nice. I feel fit enough to do this. But again, you know, I'm not here to, you know, like try to complicate minutes or anything like this. In any aspect I can help the team is why I'm here, and to continuously try to get in shape the best that I can.
Tak zeptám se, jestli jsou ještě nějaké dotazy na Blakea.
Tak se možná ještě zeptám.
Určitě.
Blake, you talked about how hard it was, how hard the year without basketball was, but could it be something blessing in this in disguise, because you have to feel recharged, maybe you are injury free, you are more hungrier, so. Do you feel that way?
Absolutely. You know, like you said, I feel recharged. My body feels very good. Even I've been working out. It feels very good. And you know, to take some time away from basketball allowed me to miss it so much more. You know, a lot of guys don't get the opportunity that I'm getting now. Once they're, you know, a year goes by, you know, they're pretty much finished. So to be able to have this opportunity again, I don't want to let it go to waste at all. And you know, every minute I'm going to be going as hard as I can. And also, it's the game that I grew up loving, you know. So I don't ever want to let it go.
Můžu ještě jednu?
Určitě, ty vždycky.
Thank you. So, Blake, of course, we cannot avoid this topic. Do you mean this return, sort of like for this summer only, or is there still like an open option for the Eurobasket?
I'm not sure. You know, I'm taking one step at a time. Really, I just want to help. In any way I can with the club now, you know, after they've already had a very good season here, you know, I want to add on to that and continue to have success here with USK. And then after, we will see, you know, with the national team and so on and so forth. But like I said, I'm just taking one step at a time right now. Of course, to be able to play another year or two would be great. But you know, I also thought this before two years ago that I would be playing, and then I never knew I would have this year off. So you know, we never know what's going to happen, and I think, you know, this last year showed everybody this, especially. So right now, I'm just living for this moment. We're here with you guys right now.
Super, tak jestliže už nejsou další dotazy, tak já bych vám moc krát chtěl poděkovat za účast a váš čas a věřím, že se zase někdy uvidíme nejenom online, ale fyzicky při podobných basketbalových příležitostech. Ještě jednou děkuju Martinovi, Peterkovi a všem za váš čas a práci.